Yes, well, good morning, everyone. Welcome to this webinar, where we will talk about our network and how we can grow the network, how we can improve the network. I think that's perhaps even more important, and at least in the end, to make it more sustainable and attractive to our SMEs and to robotic manufacturers. So that's the goal of this meeting. So you all probably have seen somewhere our website of AgroboFood. I will start with a very short brief introduction. So for the ones who are not very active already, we are divided in 7 regions. That's our network where all the activities should land and should take place. If there are people who are not connected or you would like to connect, please try to direct them to our join button, where they can register themselves as a digital innovation hub or as a business member. I think that is at least very important to have a lot of companies and liaison officers, brokers of knowledge to have them there in competence centers. So that's one start. I also would like to give a little clue how the network was set up. It was set up by the European Union, so that's the project all about. And they would like to target in first instance the competence centers. It was also based that competence centers were active in European research, but some of the research did not land very well in the industry, especially not in the small and medium enterprises. And they come up with the idea, how can we improve that? And let's start a digital innovation hub network. And they do it in all different areas. And this is the area of the agri-food robotics. And how does this network look like? How we are going to set it up is that we have, of course, these kind of competence centers. And in many cases, they also play a role as an orchestra. It could be one of the competence centers, or it could also be an office which is strongly connected to these competence centers. At least they work in a certain region, and in the region they are connected with a lot of associations, companies, liaison offices, and competence centers, and that's how we are set up. And when there is an orchestra in the middle, in a specific region, we call that also a node. And when you have different nodes together, we can build a stronger region, and it could also have an orchestra like myself. I'm the Northwest Europe coordinator, so I'm the orchestra also of different nodes where also a lot of associations and digital innovation hubs are connected. And all the regions together will serve the Pan-European network on agri-food robotics. So in Europe, we have identified or selected even 7 regions. I'm the one from Northwest Europe, and I'm also responsible for the network as a whole. But yeah, the network is a network, so I'm very much relying on the activity of the individual members, how they connect to each other. And that's what we would like to discuss today, how we can boost this even further. And if you are connected, you can join all kinds of network events. So in the left side, you see a picture of the network event we organized beginning of this year when it was still possible face-to-face. This is the network of Northwest Europe, from so Ireland, England, the Benelux together. And you can register yourself as a digital innovation hub or competence center, and then you will be aligned to the website, to our portal, where also other people can find you. And you will be visible. We are a little bit behind, but eventually it should be look something like this. You can find already many of the digital innovation hub on our portal, and you will be recognized by a few items and also be scored, so you can make it more attractive to have your services very well in line. But it's also very good to add showcases. So a showcase is a project where you advised or where you were involved with, and the more showcases you have, the more active you would look like. So it's very important to have your showcases there nicely aligned, and also explain what your role was to setting up to support showcases like this. On the other hand, you also, your customers can rate you, provide a review. It's also not very active yet, but eventually we would like to set it up that customers, because that's the best evaluation. So the market will evaluate you, and it will be directly online based on the stars, but also based on written reviews. So what can they get from you? That would be very important. And in the third place, we are building on the maturity test, where we also do a questionnaire together with you to look how mature you are and how you are able to support the SMEs in your region, other stakeholders in your region to be a good digital innovation hub. So this all together will bring you more or less to the front or to become more or less active. This is the current status of all digital innovation hubs in our region, or in the regions, so to say. So we have 7 regions, and if you look to the total members, you see more active regions and a little less active regions, but in some cases they have also a strong ecosystem. For example, France looks very small, but I know that they have a very strong ecosystem in France itself called Robert Green, and they organize it all, a lot of these things, via the Robert Green network. And that's also how it could be set up. It depends very much on the on how it is set up in specific countries. And of course, we have different services, what we can provide. And you can look here how we are divided. And we are not all on track. So there are also a lot of, and especially during this week, a lot of new entries are coming in from Digital Innovation Hub. And it will take some time before they are visible on the website. We first do a check if they are a business member or a Digital Innovation Hub. Then we make the selection, and they have to fill up more questionnaires to be part of the network. That's a little bit how it works in practice. Don't forget, if you have a specific activity in your region, to bring it in the network, and we will also list it. So all the events you can find that are related to agri-food robotics can be presented here. That's where we are for. So don't forget to share it with our network, and we will bring it also to the website. In parallel, we are working for also a more training and workshop and summer school agenda. So we identified more than 100 of these kind of trainings we have dedicated for agri-food robotics or related to agri-food robotics, and we will also bring these kind of trainings to the front in the near future. But as we are still at the beginning of our project, we need to build all these things from scratch on, so we are a little behind. If you are not connected to Basecamp, please ask your regional cluster leader to do so, because it should be very good that every Digital Innovation Hub is also connected at the back end. And so this is specifically for Digital Innovation Hub, not for specifically for business members. But Digital Innovation Hub should also be connected to Basecamp, where they have more internal in-depth information and a campfire and a message board and all relevant docs, files, logos that they can use to boost and present agrobofood even more. This is my part of the talk. I would like to hand over to my colleague Jos Balendonk. That was my name, but it should be Jos. And Jos will present a little bit more what we can offer. So he is responsible for Work Package 6. And also to bring services, and these are ecosystem services in primarily, but also the technical services and the business services that are related to agrobofood. What could we offer to the small and medium enterprises, and what could we offer between digital innovation hubs? Jos, I would like to give the floor to you.
Thank you, Eric. Am I visible, and do you see my presentation? Hello?
Yes, I can see.
Yes.
I can see it.
Thank you.
I cannot see the full screen, so I did not. I'm not sure if you shared the full screen. So I see now the presenter screen.
Okay.
Yeah, I see the screen with. I think you can make a full screen. You did not do that yet.
Yeah, where to do this?
I think you should
share. In display settings, you can change the screens. Yes, this one.
Yeah.
Wow.
Perfect.
Thank you for the support. This is how the network should work. Okay. Thank you, Eric, for this introduction. You already told a lot about the services and the network activities. The question I should address is where to find these services, and this is what I'm going to tell. Eric already told that you can, in order to get access to all these services, you have to join on the website, agrobofood.eu. And essentially, there are two types of members. You can become an associated member, which is then a digital innovation hub or a competence center, or you can become a business member. And once you get approved for membership, then you get access to Basecamp, and you will automatically receive our newsletters. And the most important thing is then that you get a contact person, which is your regional cluster leader. So he should guide you further in joining the network. If we talk about services, there are actually two types of services we talk about, and we use the definition of services defined by another digital innovation hub project called Rodin. And the first ones are the services that a digital innovation hub, so you all, can deliver to your SMEs. We call them the DIA services, from a digital innovation hub to an SME, which are shown on the left. And to the right, there are the services that the network is providing to its own digital innovation hubs. So those are the network services, or the tools we call them. And all these services are related to ecosystem services, so the network itself, to technical services and business services. So this is the definition we use. To find these services, and Eric told it already, the website maintains a public version for each digital innovation hub. And you see it here. And in case you think your display on the website is not okay, please contact the administrator of Agrobofood to update this. So have a look at the service you provide, the domains you are active, in case you're you want to add showcases and so forth, please contact us so we can update these. Another issue is that when you register for Agrobofood Network, you will automatically get newsletters. It's not only for yourself, but also for your clients. If you want to help them with the latest news on the domain agrofood robotics, please inform them to sign up for these newsletters. And we have a lot of items shown to the right in purple, like what is on our radar, are there events, is there project news, and so forth. And also, like Eric told, if you have information for this, is there something on your radar and so forth, please inform the website operator. You can send it to info@agrofood.eu, actually. Yes, what is also an idea of us is that once a new showcase is put on the website, it will be also announced in the newsletter. So that's free publicity, I think, for showcases you do together with your companies, your clients. Also, Eric mentioned already, the moment you have provided an SME with a service, technical, business, or whatsoever, please inform them to rate your performance of this service delivery on the website. So you can guide them to your website, to the place where your DIH is shown, and there you can give a ranking of your DIH. And we will be using this type of ranking also to provide yourself with feedback, and I will show that later on. Also shown already the showcases. It's shown on the website in your own tab, of course. For that, we have designed a special template, a sort of form, which you can fill in. And the moment you send this template back to us, it will be used by Draxis to put it on the website. So it can be a PDF, which can be downloaded, but it's also shown once you click on the showcases, like this here. You see there is currently one showcase on the website, which is the sweeper, as you see. But the more of this type of showcases you have, the more show off you will get for your DIH. That's it. Those are the things we promote through our website. And in the beginning of the project, actually, we found out that we also need a more private place where we can communicate with each other and we can share information. So in the beginning of the project, already we have set up Basecamp. The moment you become a member of Basecamp, you will get access to Basecamp, and it depends a little bit on which type of member you are. If you are an associate member, so a Digital Innovation of our Competence Center, you will have access to the general AgroBoo Food file where you can find documents, where you can communicate with other people and so forth. And if you are a business member, then you will have only access to the regional portals, actually, like here in red indicated, and the associate members have also access to their regional portal. These regional portals are maintained of course by the regional cluster leaders, and you are able to communicate within your region by using this. There are several things in these portals. You have a message board, you can directly connect with people in the portal, you can ping them as it said, and you can see what your own activities are and so forth. And we have set up also another way to communicate with your regions. So we have for each region, we have an email list, which is maintained actually by the regional cluster leaders. You can see them here. You can imagine neeagrobofood.eu. It's the Northeast Europe region you can address. On the website itself, you have this information about the services the Digital Innovation Hubs can provide, but we have gathered more detailed information about these services, and this detailed information is maintained on Basecamp. It's maintained in a sort of Excel file, which you can download from Basecamp, and you can download it to your own computer, so you have directly an up-to-date overview of all the Digital Innovation Hubs in the network and which services they supply. And in each service we have the different categories for the services, and we also have also the activities in those services. So in this catalog you could look for yourself, for instance, what is there, and if there is something to be updated, you can inform the administrator of Basecamp at administrator@agrobofood.eu to update this information. But this information is useful for your Digital Innovation Hub to do matchmaking for your clients. So if an SME comes with a question, where can I find somebody's working on drones? Well, you can, and for a specific find of test sites, for instance, you can use this catalog. And this catalog is fully searchable, actually. So it's an Excel file with a column where you can search, look for the search items. So here you see, for instance, a question like, can I get access to specialists' expertise in Northwest Europe? And then you have the full list of digital innovation hubs who can do this. And you can do that for each category. And also the contacts are there, and emails and so forth. Again, if you miss some information for your own digital innovation app, please inform us about such. In the first year, we also done an analysis of the needs of the digital innovation hub and the demands from the SMEs. So to have an overview of what the SMEs want and need, and what is available from the digital innovation hubs regarding services. And this is a list. In green, it's a lot. And in red, it's less, for instance. And you see, for instance, that in the top, the question provision of technical infrastructure, we have in total 52 digital innovation hubs that can provide such service, and about 3/4 of the SMEs, 73%, ask for such. And this is a sort of overview which can be used by the regional cluster leaders to actively try to fill up white spots, and seeking in digital innovation hubs can provide locally those type of requested services. This is also already shown by Eric, but here, for instance, we mapped for each region the amount of services in each category. And in red, you see where we have less services, and in green, where there is a lot. And for instance, the second and third column for contract research and data and interface standards, you see there that there's only little available there, set by the self-declaration of the digital innovation apps. So this type of columns can be used for actively building the network. Well, this is what we have currently already in available for services and tools and so forth. And this year, year two, we are trying to build what we would call the My Observatory. So if you were a digital innovation hub and you want to know how you perform, you can look into your observatory and ask questions. And this observatory will help you building your expertise. And for that, we are building this service box and a catalog of all the type of services that a network could provide. And one of those services is, for instance, the maturity tool, the self-assessment tool we've already worked on. And by using this tool and the feedback from the users, we will develop a sort of advisory tool to link you to available tools to enhance your performance, for instance. And this maturity assessment tool itself, it asks you about your management, your structure of it, and the people, the finances, the domain and services. And for each, you score according to your own ideas, a sort of ranking. And then it will finally give an overall ranking of the performance of your digital innovation apps. Think of a star system, 1 to 5 stars, for instance. And this advice, it could be useful for you to work on. This is work in progress, actually. And what we aim to do this year is first to promote the use of the existing tools by the digital innovation hubs, and then collect from you all the feedback and your comments on how you think of them by using it. And by getting feedback from you, we try to improve all these services and tools, and we will integrate them into Basecamp, in the portal or the website, and like that, built on this My Observatory. So a central place where you can log in and have an overview of active information and help. My question to the group and in the smaller groups would be, is to think about what kind of network services or tools your digital innovation hub would require to operate and to be helped, and also how your private My Observatory would look like. How what would you expect to have in such an observatory? And the other question would be, do you think a star system, like a 5-star system for ranking your performance, is something you would like to have? Or do you think, for instance, building a display on the website of your expertise and knowledge, like the success stories or the use cases and this kind of things, is that enough? So please, I invite you to give feedback to myself.
Okay. Thank you, Jos. Am I sharing already again?
Then I have to yes, close sharing.
I think I'm already sharing. So it works. So now the exciting part comes, because so we are now at the phase of loading, and we need also to be loaded by you. And we will have a look coming years about how we will make a sustainable network. Is it via business models or fees or activities? So we would like to have your input, what kind of activities we need to do, and how we can strengthen our region and learn from other regions. So from 11 to 12, we have breakout sessions. And the main questions are, what makes your region relevant and important for the agri-food robotics? And secondly, what to organize in your region? And hope we have a fruitful discussions in the separate rooms. And then during lunch, the regional cluster leader will prepare his presentation, also based on the breakout sessions. And then in the plenary afternoon session, we will try to learn from other regions. So every region will present what their activities are, how they are set up, what the strong points are from the region, what kind of main players they have in their pockets to value to other regions. And that's how we would like to continue in the afternoon. And also the input of the breakout session will be used in that presentation, but they also already prepared part of that presentation. Now the exciting part comes, because now we have to move in. I need to stop sharing, I think.
Eric?
Yeah.
Vanya Bishovac from SEMA speaking. If I can steal 1 minute from this plenary session, one suggestion, if you agree.
Yeah, okay. 1 minute.
I'll put it on my camera so you can see me. Yes, thank you. Good morning to everybody. So for those who don't know me, I'm Vanya Bishovac from SEMA. SEMA is a representative of the European Agricultural Machinery Manufacturers. And I have a suggestion related to the forthcoming discussion cluster level in parallel sessions. As you, Eric, know, and maybe some other members participants in this meeting, SEMA is considering organizing a project-related webinar where we can involve industry experts as speakers. So, but the topic, of course, the timing and the format of webinar is still to be defined. But in order to cover the needs of the agro-network, webinar, but also other stakeholders who are thinking joining our network, feedback from the regional clusters about topic which is of highest interest at this point of the project implementation for us, for the network, would be highly appreciated. Meaning it would be very, very important for us, highly appreciated, if the regional clusters can also think about the topic which they would like industry experts bring to the network. So maybe during this plenary, during this parallel session, they can also think about that and then provide feedback for us during the next plenary session
after the lunch
about that. So what is the topic we can, as the manufacturers, can bring to the network within this webinar?
I'm pretty sure that webinars will probably be an important tool to use, and there's time to address these issues, and it would be very nice to join a pan-European a webinar like Vanya is presenting. So next step, what you need to do now, Jos will...
just a very quick comment on the last question from Vanya. Yesterday in the this meeting we had with Work Package 3, so the dissemination work package, I discussed with Draxis the possibility to have on the website a sort of voting system for webinars and topics, so a public one, so that we can, on the website, post items or themes, and then we have a ranking. So we have a feedback, and then based on the higher top rankings, we could start trying to set up this kind of webinars. This is an idea, and we are very positive about this idea. So it would help Vanya in finding the topics.
We will invite Vanya to organize this as well. Next step, because it is 11 o'clock, and it is the time to move to our regional sessions. If you do not have the link, there's a link in the chat. If you look to the web page, if you link, Miriam Strauss presented the Agribal Food Regional Cluster meetings. If you press on that page, then you will be directed to your specific region, because all the regions are listed. And that's how we, perfect, Miriam. So this is where you can find it, and just press the button and you will enter a new Teams link, which is fully dedicated to your specific regions, and we have further discussions there and even a combined Slido. Thank you very much, and I hope to see you early in the afternoon. I will move to my section now as well. For everyone is clear what he needs to do. Hope everyone is now moving to other sessions. Would be perfect. Thank you very much, and hope to see you this afternoon. Misschien even bij een ander. Even aansluiten van mensen. Dat is goed.